Welcome back here to Christy Mathewson Memorial Stadium. Let's take a look at how Army scored all five of their goals. A wraparound goal by Connor Cook. That was the first of his two. Here's the second of his two. A little bit more conventional, just whizzing it past Sam Grimberg. So the Army took a 2-1 lead at that point. Then Glesner, rip one, saved by Grimberg. But then Army would get the ball back. And scoring that one was Jimbo Moore. And then Cole Johnson just pokes it past Brack McKee. Now, McKee is going to stay in goal here for the Bison. Army will go left to right on your monitor in their black jerseys. Bucknell going right to left on your screen in white jerseys. I'm Justin Answell. 5-1 Army leads. Second quarter action here from Christy Mathewson Memorial Stadium. Two ranked foes going at it, the 20th-ranked Bison and the 17th-ranked Black Knights. So four different players accounted for five of the goals for Army. Army won four of the seven faceoffs, each team with two turnovers. First offensive set piece here for Army. Good spin move. And the shot goes wide, but chasing it down is Jimbo Moore. Gunnar Miller is a very good attackman, number 24 for the Black Knights. He's got the ball right now at the 37-yard line. Couple cradles with his right. Now he's going to go left. Spin move. He'll center it. Back to Shea Mullins. Mullins has one of the five goals. Only player with two goals is Connor Cook. And he's the shortest player on either team at 5'5". Mullins is double teamed. They'll kick it back out. Another good defensive sequence here by Ben Keller. And Keller with the scoop and a cause turnover. BK22. One of four captains coming through. Good job by Ben Keller. I am a huge Ben Keller fan. And here comes the Bison. They're going to reset this. Brack McKee in goal. Now, Grimberg allowed four of the goals. McKee came in and he allowed one. He allowed the Cole Johnson goal. Here comes the Bison. Their first offensive sequence here. Henkes will kick it out to the far side. Brock Gelfie has it. Looks like it's the second team unit here getting some burn on the field. And now a couple substitutions occur. Gelfie's going to come out and Flibbett's going to come in. I want to see Flibbett grip it and rip it here. Also want to see Sean Doyle get involved. Doyle is the Joe DiMaggio of lacrosse. He has at least 1 point in 38 straight games. That's every single game of his career, and he's a junior. Flibbett, he has it. Thought about passing. Now he'll reset to Joseph at the 30. Joseph a couple cradles. He surveys the field. He's dodging right. Thought about whipping it from 12 yards out. Pass to Ryan, who slings it high. Chasing it down is Sean Doyle. You know, it's funny. Doyle and Glesner actually both have 38 straight games with at least 1 point. That's tied for sixth longest active streak in the nation. Now, Glesner already has a point today, so that streak extends to 39 games. Glesner has an assist, but Doyle's without a point. And Joseph turns the ball over. Second turnover by Ryan Joseph. And here comes a clear for the Black Knights. Look at the acceleration down the field by A.J. Canera. A quick field reversal for the Black Knights. Pass in the center. It's loose. Dotson trying to pick it up. Can Dotson get a ground ball? Yes, he can. Brad Dotson. Oh, is he ill-advised? Turnover in the back. He rushed the pass. Dotson did a great job of scooping it up. And then a very predictable pass behind the cage intended for Keller. And cutting in front of Keller was Cole Johnson. That's a turnover. So within a span of 10 seconds, Brad Dotson causes a turnover, then commits a turnover. Remember, Dotson only making his second career start. He's got great bloodlines. His sister, Audrey Dotson, is going to graduate this May. She was an outstanding player for 4 years in the women's basketball team. In fact, first team Patriot League All-League selection this past year, and the captain to the Bison squad that won 18 games, most wins in 8 years for the women's basketball team. And Audrey 6'1", Brad 6'7", so you know they've got some height and good genetics in their family. Here's Cole Johnson. Cole scored the fifth and final goal thus far of this game for Army. Glesner, feed in the center, Connor Cook, hat trick! Connor Cook, hat trick, and a score. He's now scored at least one goal in now 16 straight games, 20 goals in the season for Connor Cook out of California, Maryland. Wow. The shortest player in the team is coming up the biggest in the grandest of stages at Christy Mathewson Memorial Stadium. I mean, look at him next to Brad Dotson right now. 5'5", number 77, against number 36 in white, who's 6'7". And a goal from Connor Cook, just a bounce shot past Brack McKee. Now, if you don't like what you're seeing from McKee, you could always go to Frank Morelli, the senior walk-on keeper. Well, we're ready for the face-off here. It's 6-1 Army lead, 6 unanswered goals by the Black Knights. This is a rarity here for Bucknell. Because of the 9 games, the face-off is going to be won by the Bison as they surge up the field. Good job of winning that face-off by the Bison. But Bucknell played 9 games coming into this. 8 of them were decided by 2 goals or less. The one lopsided game was the Holy Cross game where Bucknell won 15-6. We had that game here on the Patriot League Network. Here comes Thomas Flivett. Sands back to Joseph. Joseph getting harassed by DiStefano. Joseph has a couple turnovers. Flivett without a shot. I think Flivett needs to be aggressive here. Flivett passes it back to Sands. Pass intended for Alex Ryan, and it's saved by the goalie. Intercepted. You know, to me, I think Bucknell is trying to pass the ball a little bit too much. Sometimes it's okay to be a little bit stubborn and a little aggressive. And Army caught that ball out of bounds. And the ref is yelling at Aberici, who just sprinted on the field. That's a turnover. I mean, Army caught that ball out of bounds, and so it was a late whistle. Aberici's mad, but it's a turnover nonetheless. Good job by Ryan Joseph to catch that ball in traffic. He just got slashed in the head. No foul was called. Frank is whining for a call, and was he out of bounds? Yes, he was. Good acrobatic effort by Jimbo D'April to try and save it, but he went out of bounds, so David Dixon will have the ball. The hash mark. Wild sequence right there, but it's all Army. They lead 6-1 with 9:08 to go in the second quarter. Now, it's important for Bucknell to try and get back in this game now because Army owns the third quarter as well. Army's outscoring opponents 32-15 in the third quarter this season.